What's up, YouTube? My name's Mike Steele, and I make stuff. And this is a little tour of the studio where I make stuff. I'm an independent artist and designer, mostly self-taught. And this is some of the stuff I like to keep around for inspiration. It's more inspiration in here than art, to be honest. But you gotta stay inspired. I don't have a whole lot in here, but I've got a couple 3D printers and tablet PC, my drafting table, small workbench. But it serves its purpose, and I've managed to create an independent toy line and comic book series. And I'd like to make a series of videos explaining my processes and my techniques, and hopefully help some folks learn some things they maybe haven't seen or heard before. Now that you guys have had a tour of my dusty old studio, I'm gonna jump right into designing some action figures. It's non-photo blue pencil, it's a rubber eraser, or plastic eraser rather, and a mechanical pencil, 0.5 with blue lead in it. Just laying out my head height for my character. Usually about 5.5 to 6 heads high is normal. Normal 6 foot person. 6 heads high is 6 heads to 7 heads high is a superhero stature. But these are just some normal old space pilots. Sketching out some landmarks of his uniform. So I want his collar to line up somewhere in the middle of his beard. Just really lightly sketching. I like these pencils because this color blue, and really any color blue close to this, and some greens and some pinks, you don't have to erase them because it's harder for the scanner to see these colors. So they show up really light anyway, and it's really easy to turn them off to get rid of the color in Photoshop. But I use all the kind of pencils. This is just much cleaner, doesn't smudge. I also work mostly digitally, but I just wanted to show that you don't have to have a tablet, you don't have to have Photoshop, you know, to sketch your ideas out. Just loosely sketching out his outfit here, his spacesuit. Just really making some landmarks. Cause I don't, you know, it's more just a guide. When I go in and really draw this guy, I may not be totally faithful to these lines I'm making right now. Just trying to puke my ideas out, you know, onto the paper. And this is also sped up. This is twice as fast as I was actually drawing. And I actually just skipped ahead in the editing. I cut out the sketching of the side profile just for time saving. But you will see me ink both of these. And I'm not using any type of special pen. This is just I think it's a 0.5 ballpoint. It's just a pen from Walgreens. I usually start on the face. I don't know, I was confident I started outline and then I jump back to the face. You know, because if you do all that work and then you come in and screw the face up. I mean, you can come in and, you know, use some white out and make repairs, but I'd rather not if I don't have to. I'm doing two views here because, I mean, this is something I'm designing myself. Usually in drafting or engineering, you need a minimum of three views, the top, side, front, in order to make something, to make a part. But I'm not going to do a top for time reasons, and also because when it comes to sculpting this, I mean, I'm designing it anyway. You know, so really, sometimes I don't even do two views. But if it's something you're designing for someone else to model or sculpt, you're going to want to give as many views as possible. And this is just initial concepting. I'm not thinking about articulation and or joints and, you know, how this guy will move. I'm just working on the look right now, and I'll think about that later. I may do a whole nother set of turnaround sketches with articulation in mind. Sometimes it's not necessary. You can just work that out in the sculpting phase. But I just want a general idea right now of what this guy's going to look like. And the more work you put in it, the more texture, the more shading, the more detail. It's just the easier it's going to be for you later in sculpting it. When you're you know, finding the shape and trying to decide texture for your model. And it's just time saving. The more you think about the design now, the less you have to think about it in the sculpting phase. Or the less someone else has to think about it in the sculpting phase. I think, switch back to the mechanical pencil here, because I didn't just want to go straight in and ink the hands, because hands are challenging. And I didn't want to do any repairs on this page. I wanted to try and get it, bang it out in one shot. Hands are still tough, and I draw almost every day. Have been for probably maybe 30 years, and hands are tough. I think, yeah, I still look at reference probably every time I do hands. And I am moving pretty quick through this, even though this is sped up. I'm drawing quicker than I usually would be for video's sake, because I'm usually pretty slow. And I have shaky hands. That's why I grip the pen like a madman. It's my dampening mechanism. So you could see, even with the inking, I'm fairly loose. I'm not 100% faithful to the sketch. But I try to stay as close as possible when it comes to sculpting this. You know, I try to keep it as close to the original design as possible. That's the idea anyway. I draw a lot of astronauts, and I have a fascination with space helmets and helmets in general. And I think it probably comes from my childhood. My godmother worked for NASA during the Apollo program, and in the 80s when I was a kid, she no longer worked for NASA, but anytime we would go on a tour to Michoud test facility in New Orleans, Louisiana, it would be like going to Willy Wonka's with the golden ticket, because she knew everybody, and we would get to go behind the scenes and, you know, talk to people, and I got to meet astronauts, and it's just a really impactful experience as a kid. So I have a fascination with the space program, especially when I was a kid. Also, I remember my mom had bought me this children's book called How to Build Your Own Spaceship, or How to Build a Spaceship. And it was about this kid who it just had a crazy imagination, and he built a spaceship out of cardboard boxes, and I don't really remember the whole story, but just out of junk, you know, like tape and junk. And I think it was just, it was mostly all in his mind, like all his fantasy, but, you know, he ends up flying the spaceship. But it really, I think that's where I get my mindset of, you know, taking what I have and making what I want out of it. I've always really had that mindset with anything I become interested in. Cars, you know, that's always been my mindset. Just really anything I've wanted to do or learn, you know, I've really just kind of done it on my own, or figured it out on my own, or figured out a cheaper, easier way to do it. And I think that probably, that also, you know, comes from my childhood. Really, a lot from that book, I think. The How to Build Your Own Spaceship book. It's crazy, little things like that have such a long-lasting impact. I'm still trying to build my own spaceship. Back to the sketch. I'm going a little quicker on these hands. A little more confident now. I did them from one perspective. They don't, you know, and they don't totally match the other perspective, but it's close enough to be a guide for sculpting. I think the head matches pretty well. Back to what I was saying about, you know, being mostly self-taught and learning on my own. That's why I don't really call this a tutorial. This is more how I do things, you know, because it may not necessarily be what some people would call the right way or the way it should be done, but it's the way I do things, and it works for me, and it might work for you. Happier with the side profile. It's looking a little heavy from the front profile. I think I go in and taper him out a little bit before it's finished. We're not going to go much further than this in this video, but I will put a little clip in at the end and show the finished action figure. That will inevitably make from this design. And in later videos, I'll show the process behind making that, because this is just the beginning. There are a lot of steps in going from a concept or a design to a physical prototype. And it can be really time consuming, but with practice and repetition, you can get the production pipeline down pretty quick. I'm going in here and adding a few details, but I'm really just messing around. So here, as promised, is the figure.